When you think of political parties, you think of Democrat or Republican. Truth is, just about any group can stake a claim at becoming a political party, no matter how big or small. WLKY's Duane Pullman shows us how a small group in Louisville focused on slavery is now a legitimate party with candidates on this year's ballot.
Witnessing
there is a successful rout.
Amen.
The birth of a religious and political movement.
We are descendants of American slaves.
The descendants of American slaves is officially Kentucky's newest political party.
How are you?
Fine.
Headquartered here at this humble church on the west side of Louisville.
I'm not afraid of the political arena because you told me that you would be with me every step of the way.
The descendants of American slaves gathers each Sunday to pray and politic.
You said if I ever needed you to call you, well, Father, I need you. I need you, Father, because I can't hardly do this by myself.
Retired businessman Norris Shelton hatched the idea, first as a movement.
This is the start of something that should have been done years and years ago.
And now, as a political party.
Because of the cover-up of slavery, there is an entire group of people in America who are not being properly represented in our political arena.
Shelton is running for state senate. Henry Owens is running for state rep. Mark Wooten is going for the conservation district. All are on the ballot as members of the Descendants of American Slaves political party. The party's platform is simple. First, to recognize not African Americans, but descendants of slaves.
Legally and on paper, they are not being represented.
And to pay reparations for that slavery.
Most people look at that as a negative. They say, oh, here they come again and want some more welfare. Well, that's not necessarily true.
Only by addressing the original sin of slavery, Shelton says, can Louisville, Kentucky, and the country reverse discrimination, violence, and despair now gripping our cities.
That's why we see all these killings and murders in the West End and so much crime and violence. And
I believe that change is necessary sometimes.
Amen.
While some may dismiss these sights and sounds, Shelton is sure that his grassroots group will grow into a larger movement that will sweep the country.
I see this as being as large as the American Civil War.
One believer at a time.
Jesus lifted me.
That's why.
I'm Duane Pullman, WLKY News.
Shelton is running against State Senator Gerald Neal. Neal is the first African-American man elected to Kentucky Senate and has served in the state legislature longer than any other African-American. Later in the month, we'll focus on both candidates.